Want to get you up to speed on the big story of the day, the outcome, of course, of the presidential election. Votes still being tallied in multiple states, including Arizona, Pennsylvania, Georgia, and Nevada. The Biden campaign saying it is confident former Vice President Joe Biden will win the election. Meantime, President Trump pursuing lawsuits for recounts in multiple states. And we are joined this morning, as ever, by our good friend Eamon Javers, who joins us with the latest. Eamon.
Yeah, good morning, Andrew. Take a look at the map of the country, and you'll see where we are right now as the vote count creeps forward in states across the country. Last night, into the night deeply, we saw Joe Biden now holding at 253 Electoral College votes, Donald Trump at 214, and you see the gray states there. That's where we're waiting on additional vote in order to fill this map out. The race is to 270, as everyone knows by now. So take a look state by state at some of the updates that we got late yesterday, starting in Arizona. There you see the vote count. Biden 50.5, Trump 48.1, a difference of 68,000 and change between those two men. The vote count goes on there, 86% of the vote total in Arizona. In Nevada, something similar going on as they continue to pull this together, 49.3% for Joe Biden, Trump 48.7%, 86% of the vote in Nevada. Now let's switch over to Georgia, which is an unusual one because this is not a state where you would assume that Democrats would be competitive this year. They have been, but perhaps not competitive enough, 49.6% for Donald Trump, 49.1 for Joe Biden, a difference of 23,000. Vote counting goes on there, particularly in Fulton County. That's where Atlanta is, and that's where the Biden folks hope to pick up some votes. We'll see whether it can be enough. And I think we have Pennsylvania as well to focus in on this morning as we talk about where everything stands. This is one that the Biden campaign really had hoped to win over, 50.7 for Trump right now, 48.1 for Biden, a difference of 164,000. Vote counting goes on there, 89% of the vote in. We'll see where that vote comes from and whether that makes a difference in the outcome here. But the president leading in the state of Pennsylvania and its hefty 20 electoral college votes there. Meanwhile, we saw protests across the country erupt yesterday as protesters for and against Donald Trump took to the streets, starting in a number of cities. We saw Philadelphia count every vote rallies there. We saw rallies in Pittsburgh as well, Boston, and New York City. We also saw, so those are the anti-Trump protesters. They are calling for every vote to be counted in those battleground states. We also saw some protesters showing up in Maricopa County in Arizona, hoping to stop the vote count, working with President Trump, or at least on his behalf, arguing that the vote there needed to be stopped because their alleging irregularities have been going on. So we're seeing the tension boil here, but a very legal and for most of the country, very calm process of simply doing the drudgery of counting all these ballots that Americans went to the trouble of casting this week, guys.
Yeah. Well, it's funny because depending on which side you're on, you want them to count them in certain places, but no, stop in the other places. It's bizarre.
Right.
Arizona.
Either you're for counting ballots or you're not, right?
True. But I think that you need to explain to us how the Supreme Court, and I'm not talking about a new challenge, I'm talking about that Roberts decision, which allowed Pennsylvania to go 3 days after, and they're doing some kind of weird, they're appealing to Democrats to, do you know, it's very arcane and nuanced. Are you with me on this, Eamon? Do you know what could
happen? Yeah, I can't walk you through the intricacies of Pennsylvania, the legal system there, but... one of the issues is what the president has said is that you don't want to see these mysterious votes showing up overnight. He's alleging that there are new votes being cast after the election, and there's just no evidence of that. So the president has spent the past, 24, 48 hours alleging fraud in all of these states, and we just haven't seen that. The president's legal challenges broadly are going to rest on this idea that somebody did something illegal somewhere. In order for that strategy to be successful, they're going to have to find some of that. And we just haven't seen it yet.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.